Straight up, now tell me, do you really wanna love me forever? Oh, oh, oh. Or is it just a hit and run? Hey, we got a good thing. Don't know if I'ma see you again.
Hello, everybody. It's Amber. It's another Whoa Wednesday where we talk about the things that are blowing up in our fandom. Okay, so I have posted my last Whoa Wednesday on Monday, because I was too late to post it on the last Wednesday, and I didn't want to wait till this Wednesday because then it was going to be longer than it needed to be. It just would have been too much, okay? But after this Whoa Wednesday, I'm going to be posting more stuff, you know, more reactions, more original content that I've made up, you know, more me kind of stuff. Which, you know, Whoa Wednesday is me kind of stuff, but you know what I'm saying? Like, I've been slacking, and I gotta fix that, so I'm gonna be fixing that. But right now, we're going to be doing Whoa Wednesday. There's not really that much drama happening, which is always a good thing. But there is gonna be a lot of things that I'm gonna be possibly updating a lot of you on, for anybody who doesn't know, this is nada than this, whatever's whatever, okay? Let's do this. As always, we'll be starting off with the least problematic, which this week is Louie. Louie hasn't really been doing much at all. This is a recent picture that he had posted of himself on Instagram. Earlier today, somebody had tweeted him and had said, do something for your Louie's. You know, he says, sit tight, really excited about the next single video shoot soon. It's really, really good to know that he is still indeed doing what he wants to do. You know what I mean? Like, that wasn't the only single that we're going to be getting, is the one that featured him and Steve Aoki, okay? So, Aoki. I said his name all wrong. It's good to know that he's ensuring us that there will be a single still coming, and that he's doing a video shoot. All right then, we're gonna be shook. Also, there's speculations going around saying, is Louis Tomlinson going to replace Mel beyond America's Got Talent? So maybe that's something that he's been working on as well, because, you know, he's kind of been in the shadows, so maybe that's what he's been working on. Maybe he's been, like, filming for some things or something, you know what I'm saying? So we can't necessarily know just yet, but I'm pretty sure Louis is going to shake us all really, really soon. That's all I have with Louis, so now we're going to be moving on to Zayn. Again, Zayn hasn't really been doing much either. This was him in New York. This is him still in New York with Gigi. This was also him with a video director. So, this is a video director. I'm just assuming that he's going to be dropping new music as well. There were speculations, not speculations, but there was things of him saying that he's supposed to be dropping a second album really, really soon. That was like a couple months ago where he announced that. So, hopefully it's going to be coming really soon. Because I'm ready to hear more songs from, more music from Zayn. Like, come on, buddy, where are you? That's really all I have with Zayn, too. I mean, Zayn's really been in the shadows as well. So, the next person we're going to be moving on to is Harry. Harry hasn't necessarily been in the shadows. He's actually been very, very active. But a lot of the active stuff I've already told y'all. So, these are just a couple recent things. If you don't already know, Harry is hosting with James Corden on the Late Late Show every single night this week. He was on Monday and Tuesday, and he's going to be on tonight. It was announced that he's going to be doing carpool karaoke with James, which is amazing. It's so great. I think it's supposed to be coming out on Friday, so Friday is going to be busy. I think it's Friday. Now, don't hold me on that, but I think it is Friday. And if it's not Friday, it's supposed to be coming really soon because they keep announcing it, okay? The first night he had performed Sign of the Times live. I was in tears. Oh my gosh. I never thought that he could really top the first time I had heard him sing it live, but I was stood corrected because Harry can sing, okay? That boy can sing. The second night, Tuesday night, he had performed Carolina. It was really, really good as well. So, I'm going to link both of those performances down below so that you can go and check them out. Remember that he's going to be on tonight performing who knows what. So be there. Be square. Ticketmaster say, fans, we have heard your feedback. Here are the details for Harry Styles Verified Fan ticket process and things of that sort. So I had already told y'all in the last video that I posted about the whole ticket fraud and the whole ticket situation and how there were scammers who ended up getting the tickets instead of actual fans and stuff. Well, Ticketmaster are trying to redeem themselves and they're trying to make things better. But they are trying, so I give them that. It says Ticketmaster tweeted Harry tour tickets details. They go back on sale tomorrow and only verified fans have access to them. 2 ticket limit. I guess that's just for anybody who didn't get a chance to get tickets, because there were some people who did get a chance to get tickets that weren't scammers, but a lot of people didn't get a chance to get tickets. But this came out yesterday, so if you don't already know about it, I said you go check and see if there are still tickets in your town and see if you can still get you some. That would be my advice to you. There, Lele show last night, he was in the first skit. He was like hosting in the very beginning, did such an amazing job, so proud of him. He's killing it, you know, he's killing the game. I'm gonna link his skit down below as well so you can go and watch it, because you gotta watch it. I think tonight also he's supposed to be in a skit with James where they're gonna be like at an operating table or something. So, you know, it's really something that you don't want to miss, like seriously, honestly, truly. It seems like ever since Harry went solo, it seems like he's more himself, which is crazy because you would think that he would not be more of himself than what he already was. But I feel like him going solo really shows how closed in of a person he was in One Direction interviews. Like, he's nothing compared to how he is now. And it's amazing because I feel like it's the first time I'm actually seeing Harry, you know, ever, you know, and it's kind of like a beautiful kind of feeling in a way, honestly, if I'm getting all sappy with you, to be honest, because he just seems so, like, so free. He seems so willing. Like, he just tells you what's on his mind, and he's actually hilarious. Like, not saying that he never was funny, but he really is funny. Like, his personality is the best, and Harry just be slaying me, like, seriously, just naturally. So be sure you go check him out, because he needs you. All I have with Harry, so now we're going to be moving on to Liam. Here's just a few updates from Liam. It says Liam confirmed that he's gonna dance on tour. Liam accidentally used 1D in a past tense and apologized. Liam also confirmed that there is a music video that he dances in, which is legit. Liam confirmed that his album is basically finished. Liam said Niall texted him this morning asking when the album was coming out. Liam said the album is a mix of very R&B and rap, and he's gonna dance. He said he doesn't like pineapple pizza. Hilarious. Is Liam looking fine as ever? Liam is going to be having a solo single come out this Friday, bitch. You gotta be there. It'll be called Stripped Down, and it features Quavo. Quavo is one of the Migos, in case you don't know that. You don't know Migos, look them up. You'll know who they are, okay? But I'm really, really, really excited because it feels like it's been forever since we heard anything. And now we only gotta wait 2 days, 1.5 days, or whatever, until we can actually hear Liam's music. So I'm really, really excited. I don't think there's an official date on when his album's gonna come out, but I mean, him giving me this single is enough right now, okay? So it's all good. This is Liam for Billboard. This was him at XM Sirius. This is him at the Z100 today at an interview. Him meeting a couple fans. You know, he's just really doing him, like, seriously. And he's doing interviews. I haven't really seen an interview with him just yet, so I don't know if these are, like, pre-recorded interviews and we're going to see them later, or if they're already out and ain't nobody told me. I'm not 100% sure, but this is something that I'm just really, really excited about. I'm really, really, really excited to hear about what Liam is going to be serving us. You understand me? But that's all I have with Liam. So now we're going to be moving on to Niall. Niall was at Wango Tango, and he had performed a new song that's called On the Loose. I heard some of it, actually, and it actually seems really, really good. I haven't heard a lot of it, but I did hear some of it from his live performance. I'll link his performance down below. And I'm actually ready for the song, but I need a studio version. Like, this isn't enough for me, you know what I mean? I need a studio version. This was him after he had performed with a couple fans. And this is him at the SoCal Honda stage. Apparently he had sung This Town, On the Loose, and Slow Hands. I can find this performance as well. I'll link it down below. And then this was him in LA with a couple fans. And then he won an award for Radio Disney. He's slaying the game. Now Horan Talks debut album reveals release timeline. It's just completely me. So it says, in the fall, start of winter, I guess. Decided to ride it out, see what happens, and then kind of let people know when I'm ready to go. That's around whenever he wants his album to drop. So we're just gonna have to wait until, when did he say? In the fall, start of winter. So that's like towards the end of the year. Thanks a lot. We gotta wait too long. It's too long. But you know, it is coming. So that's really good. That's really, really exciting. Also, he had tweeted and said, tune into Ellen's show tomorrow. So there's something you gotta do. Make sure you watch Ellen tomorrow because he's gonna be on there. I'm not sure if he's gonna be performing or if he's just going on there for an interview or if he's just going over there to see his doppelganger. Who knows? It's gonna be amazing. I just know it's gonna be amazing because everything Niall does is amazing. That's all I have with Niall. So make sure that y'all go and check out everybody's music. Everybody's gonna be having music out. You know, we're just gonna be having music just from all of OT5 and where we're gonna be slayed, you guys. We're gonna be on the floor. I'm so ready for it. I live for OT5 to rise, you know what I mean? So it's really cool and it's really, really exciting. But that's all I have for you guys this Wednesday. Told you it wasn't a lot. It's not really a whole bunch. But I mean, if you do have any questions, remember that you can always comment them down below and I will surely answer them anytime that I get a chance. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have an amazing day. If there was anything that I had missed, feel free to comment it down below so that anybody else who doesn't know about it can know about it, including me. If there's anything that you ever feel like I will miss in Woe Wednesdays, remember you can always DM me on Instagram or Twitter. They're linked down below. And always the conclusion of this video, follow me on all my social medias because I'm lit. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. I love y'all so much. And I will surely see y'all next time. Remember to be head up and smile and always let somebody have your back.